What's going on, guys, and welcome back to Life by the Bow. I am pumped today because it is such a beautiful day, number one, and number two, you guys have been asking for it, so today we're gonna do a walkthrough of our Contender 30ST. So if you came across this video and by any means you're looking into buying a Contender, one particularly in this size, you're in luck, because this boat is for sale, $179,999. So before we actually get to the boat and we do the walkthrough, I'm gonna talk a little bit about the boat itself, where it may fit you, where it fits me, and overall what just makes it such a great boat. So something that's great about this 30, and really Contenders in particular, is the draft. I mean, this boat drafts 20 inches, which is less than 2 feet. So that gives you the ability to get up into all these shallow bait spots, get up nice and shallow at the sandbar. On the other hand, the boat still maintains a really deep V. So that's gonna make the boat extremely offshore capable. Reason why, the sharper the entry you have, say for example, like a knife cutting through water, the better and softer the boat's gonna ride. One thing I love about this boat and Contenders in general is their lines. Everything makes perfect sense ergonomically from front to back. It's got a nice narrow speedboat type look to it, but at the same time, it still has a relatively subtle bow flare. The reason why that bow flare is important is just because with a deep V, when that boat cuts through the water, that water wants to come up. But with the bow flare, when that water's coming up, it shifts its direction around and out away from the boat. So that's gonna equate to a soft and dry ride. Another thing I'd like to add is this boat has a double stepped hull. That's the difference between a T model Contender and an ST. T is no steps, obviously the ST has the steps. And I gotta tell you, I absolutely love step hull boats. Reason why is because I like getting places fast and I like getting places burning as little fuel as possible. And that's where this boat shines. The double steps, they really do work. Basically what it is, it's an indentation in the bottom of the hull, gives the boat less wet surface. When you have less wet surface, you have less drag, more speed, better fuel economy. At the same time, this boat, it gets up and goes and it rides on top of the waves at high speeds, flawlessly, keeping in mind the deep V, bow flare, whatever else you may want to add about the boat. This boat is meant to go, it's meant to go fast, and it's intended to do all of that while burning the least amount of fuel as possible, and it shines in that aspect, and that's a big reason why I love this boat. But anyway, I'm gonna stop talking, I'm gonna get into the walkthrough, the reason why you guys came here for this video. But I have to say it is a really sad day just because there's been so many great memories made out of this boat, and that wouldn't be possible if it weren't for the great people at Contender. They've always taken care of us since day one, and they truly do build an exceptional product. They wouldn't have been in business as long as they have if it weren't for them building great boats. Furthermore, let's go through some of the key features, why we designed the boat the way that we did. Hopefully it helps you make your decision on your next center console, and hey, maybe this one will be yours. All right, guys, so here we are up in the bow. Basically, the way we're gonna do this walkthrough is from front to back. Let's get started. The first thing I'm gonna talk about is this pop-up bow light and this pop-up cleat. The reason why these are so important on a fishing boat, say for example, you're up here, you're loading the cast net. These are two things that can be completely tucked away. Therefore, you never have to worry about anything ever getting caught up on your cast net up here on the bow. I've also seen instances of someone running up to the bow of a boat and they actually split their toes between a cleat, had to go to the hospital, get stitches, and that's never any fun. So if it's not in use, it needs to be able to be removed or tucked away, like I said, on a fishing boat specifically. Down here in the cockpit, you'll see something that you don't really see on a lot of Contenders. And basically what that is the luxury sport options. We wanted to do something a little different. We wanted the boat to stand out. So therefore we incorporated the luxury sport cup holders inside of the bolsters here up on the bow. And then we also added the speaker pods. So that's something that's a really nice touch that you know, you don't see on your most basic model contenders. It just gives it kind of like a sportier look, and also works just very, very well when you're up here kind of just enjoying sitting on the forward seats. Speaking of forward seats, this is something I absolutely love about this boat. The reason why, because it gives it such a sporty, comfortable look, which is very appealing to the family. At the same time, it's very functional on this fishing platform because they don't extrude too much. There's still plenty of room up here to fight a sailfish, move around, do what you have to do. But at the same time, it also serves as a great step to get up from here up to the bow in case you want to throw the cast net like I had mentioned earlier. When we're talking in terms of comfort, when the cushions are here, we obviously have them removed because we had the boat set up for fishing just a couple days ago. It makes a great area where everybody can just kind of come up here, hang out, sit back, relax. This is personally like one of my favorite positions in the forward seating because it's like a big lazy boy chair. It's just another great option that Contender gives you to add to this semi-custom boat to make it yours. And this is something we've always really appreciated. Lastly, these large hatch openings here on the forward seats give you a lot more storage in the boat. We do a lot of trips to Key West, the Bahamas. So the more storage that we have, obviously the better. On the floor up here in the bow, we have this massive insulated fish box. We've had swordfish up here. You could fit big tunas, big dolphin, suitcases, bean bags, anything that has a large surface area will fit up here. And that's something I really appreciate because when you're running over to the Bahamas or you need that space for all the fish that you're gonna catch in the boat, this is the number one place that you're gonna put it just because there's so much room. A little further back, we have another insulated fish box. This works great as a cooler. We use this a lot to bring ice over to the Bahamas just because it's not too big, but it's just that perfect size. Also works great for bumpers, cast nets, buckets. Moving to side, these are hatches that we don't really use too much, but I do recall times running over to the Bahamas. You know, we put drinks in there, chips, food, just more storage. The more storage you got, the better. Right here, we have the upgraded sport console, and I love this console. Reason why is because it's so big. You're in rough seas or you get caught out in a storm and you're behind this console, you are 150% dry. It also gives you a lot more head space inside. Gives you a lot more storage. In addition to that, you have this huge cushion, the seat, which also opens up to be a hatch or a cooler, whichever you may prefer. We also upgraded to an Isan glass enclosure. I love this. It's clear as day. Another thing to note is this hard top. We also added the extra large hard top to give us more shade. Notice the curvature and the lines, the way it's shaped. There's a lot of craftsmanship that went into this T-top in order to make it the shape that it stands right now. So that is something that is huge. It really adds to the lines of the boats. And it really just goes to show how Contender really just goes that extra step to just build a really great boat. Further back, we have the whiteout powder coating package here. And as you can see, it really ties the boat together really, really well. Though aluminum looks great, this is a personal touch that we really believe just kind of makes the boat stand out. Above us, you can see we got the speaker pods, and these look just as great as they are functional. When you're at the sandbar and you're hanging out, these really open up the stereo, just make it so much more clear. These are 7.7s. We also have 7.7s up in the bow, as you saw, 210s, 8.8s here in the cockpit, and then also the 6.5s. So this boat definitely does bump. Here we are on the back side of the console, and like I'd mentioned before, this thing is just massive, and what I love about that, in addition to everything I mentioned before, is there's so much real estate on the backside here to just mount whatever you may wish. Obviously, enough room for two 12-inch Garmin screens. You could even go bigger if you wanted to. There's still enough room for two VHFs. Obviously, here we have our gauge mounted. Enough room for a head unit, autopilot. Whatever you want to put here, you can basically put it here. The reason why we went with two screens versus one, just in case one unit does go down, you still have an extra when you're over in the islands or you're somewhere, I guess you could say, away from home. You still always have that extra just in case you need it. It's even happened to me. I've had one go down and I was very glad I had another. I love the way that we laid out the console here because you can get right in the middle. You have your steering wheel on one side and then you have your throttles on the other. The reason why I like this in the center is just because I can still have two people sitting on either side of me while I'm up here driving the boat. Trim tab switches right where they need to be, right beside the throttle, so I can go back and forth very easily. Cup holders on either side. You can add as many as you want, take away as many as you want. Just another great feature of Contender being a semi-custom boat. Behind the console, we have what I call the hot seats. And the reason why I call them the hot seats is because if somebody's not already sitting here, somebody wants to be sitting here. These Lebroc Helm chairs are so comfortable. If you're building a Contender or you're buying a Contender, I highly suggest that you have these things on the boat. Not only are they comfortable, but they're extremely functional. One thing that I love is depending on what you're doing, like in a rough sea, I always like to flip these forward just because they lock me in a little better. But if I'm just kind of cruising and I want a little more room, or I'm going around the cockpit because I'm fishing or I'm rigging right here or something, I have the option to flip these straight up and out of the way. Same thing with the armrest. You just press the button. These go straight up, completely out of the way, extremely functional, extremely comfortable. I highly suggest these. A little further down, we have the frigid rigid cooler that slides in and out on a track. It keeps ice easily just as long as a Yeti. It has a nice shine to it, and it literally looks like it's part of the boat versus a piece that was just added in later on. So I really, really appreciate that. The fact that it goes in on a track too and it's completely gone and out of the way is huge for the fishability of the boat. So that's just another great feature that Contender implemented into this leaning post specifically in order to just make this a better all-around functioning fishing boat. Behind the leaning post, we have the grab handle slash rod rack. Like I mentioned, the boat's a double step bottom boat, likes to go fast, so you want to make sure you have something to hold on to. And the fact that it doubles as a rod rack is so important, man. Something to note about this rod rack and also the rod holders in the T-top. You always want to make sure when you're building a fishing boat that you have somewhere within the center of the boat, or I guess you could say the middle of the boat, to put all of your fishing rods. Whether it's behind the leaning post, the T-top, on the side of the console. The reason why, because you wanna make sure your fishing platform is completely unobstructed. For example, say I have fishing rods inside of all my rod holders right here, right? I pull up on a school of dolphin. All of a sudden, I gotta go out and I gotta make a cast. I can't do it if I have fishing rods sitting here. So when you're building your boat, you should always make sure you have places in the middle where the rods are completely out of the way, so you have fishability all the way around your boat to cast, put a bait out, whatever you have to do. Referencing towards the beginning of the video, like I was saying, anything that's on a fishing boat should either be able to be tucked away or removed from the boat whenever it's not in use. And that's the case with this rear bench seat. Literally 2 snaps, 2 seconds, removes off the boat, leave it on the dock, it's gone. So that's a really nice touch when it comes to the fishability of the boat. But at the same time, like I said, we really enjoy crossings to the Bahamas, going to the sandbar. So when we're done fishing for the day, we come back to the dock real quick, we pick this thing up, we put it on the boat, and you have just a really, really nice bench seat back here. Honestly, besides the helm chairs, this is one of my favorite places to sit in the boat. And it's just a really nice touch, adds to that sport look and overall comfort of the boat. All right, so now that the bench seat is removed, this is where all the magic happens. And what I mean by that is the fishing. These are 2 insulated fish boxes. They're obviously mirroring, same exact thing on either side. They don't look very big, but if you get down in there, you can see that they go all the way to the back of the boat here. They're plenty big enough just for a simple day out fishing here in the Keys. We fill them up with dolphin, grouper, snapper, tunas, and we've never had a problem overfilling them, so they're plenty big enough. The other thing that's great about these hatches in the back, you know, if you're running out of room for drinks in the cooler here, you could always use either one as a cooler. Like I said, they're insulated. So anything that's insulated is gonna be a great cooler. This isn't a fishing feature, but I cannot let this go and I cannot stress the importance of this. This is access to the bilge. And if this is your first boat, you've never been around boats, bilge access is tremendous. The reason why, because everything that basically is most important, I shouldn't say most important, but there are a lot of important things in here that do need to work. And the fact that I can get my entire body inside of this bilge to work on my pumps, my float switches, my fuel water separators, my trim tab pumps, whatever it may be, I can literally get my entire body down inside of there and take a nap even if I wanted to. So that's something that's huge. Something I forgot to mention too, console's the same exact way. Once you get inside of the console, there's tremendous access to all of your wiring, your amplifiers, the back of your GPS screens, steering pump, basically anything and everything that you would need to get to. Here in the transom, we have a twin live well setup. And this is something that's very important for us here in Southeast Florida. Reason why is because our fish can be really, really spooky. So therefore, sometimes we're required to use live bait, almost always using live bait, depending on the species. There's definitely a difference between a great live well and a bad live well. These, on the other hand, are great live wells. Reason why is because they have round corners. The reason why round corners are important, just because it's gonna allow that bait to move very freely. They won't get stuck in those corners, and when they're moving freely, moving in circles, you know, they're getting enough oxygen flow for their gills. Therefore, that's gonna equate to a healthier bait. In addition to that, these wells are pressurized. The reason why a pressurized well is important is because if you could imagine, say, a bottle of water, obviously, if there's air inside of that water bottle, that water is gonna move. But if that water, or say this water bottle was full all the way to the top, and you went to shake it, that water's not gonna move because there's no air. Same concept applies here. If your live wells are completely full of water, your water's not gonna move. So basically your baits are just gonna be chilling in this live well, and they're not gonna be getting beat up. These wells are in the transom, which is where I believe is the best place for them. The reason why, say you throw the net off the bow, you come down the gunnel, you come to pull your bait inside of the boat, you drop it straight in the well. I see manufacturers putting live wells in their leaning posts, and then they'll do a rod rack right over the top of the live well, very similarly to this, but if you could imagine, right underneath it, we have that bait well. So the problem with that is when you come bring your bait over the side of the boat and you want to drop it in your well, you can't because you have this rod rack here. So the fact that these are in the transom, they're unobstructed. You can bring a bait net straight over the side of the boat, right into the well. That's what makes these a great functioning live well in addition to everything else I just mentioned. Beside the wells here, we have this opening, which allows you to step freely straight through this dive door here. If you got somebody that's a little older on the boat, this is perfect for them because it's just less obstruction that they have to work over in order to get in and out of the boat. We also have the Garelick in transom collapsible ladder where these legs actually fold out and then it hides away straight back inside of the boat, which is awesome. Below that, we have Mercury K-plane trim tabs, which work fantastic with this boat. Just enough to get that bow down in rough seas to kind of just plow through everything. Last but not least, we got the Yamaha 300 four-strokes on the back. And if you know boats, you know these are the cream of the crop when it comes to 300 horsepower. I mean, these things just have proven reliability. They continue to run for thousands of hours. And this power package specifically for this boat is perfect. The best I've seen is 68 miles an hour. Realistically, you won't see that. You'll probably see around 65, 66. Best cruise speed, you're looking at 2 miles per gallon. And that's going about 35, 38 miles per hour. And then if you want to do a little faster cruise, you're probably looking at 45 miles an hour, 1.7 miles per gallon. Which is tremendous. Overall, I believe topped out, say for example, doing 65 miles an hour, you're burning 1.2 miles per gallon. So if you really want to open these motors up, you know, you can still do that and not really have to worry about burning too much gas. Last but not least, we added all Gemlux rod holders to the boat. If you can notice, they don't have any screws, so it just adds a really clean look to all the hardware. Also, four of them are cup holder slash rod holders, so it kind of just adds to the essence of the boat being like a sandbar slash fishing boat. Also, we added under gunnel rod storage here in the rear. We don't really use that for rods just because there's so many rod holders already on the boat. We just needed a place to keep our gaffs, and that was the perfect option and something that you'll really appreciate if you have one of these boats. So I hope you guys enjoyed the walkthrough, whether you're looking into buying a 30-foot center console, a Contender, one like this specifically. It's so cool the amount of options that Contender gives you in order to build these boats and spec them out the way that you want them. There's multiple leaning post options, multiple T-top options, multiple configurations in order to build the boat towards your needs. And that's something we really appreciate from them. Like I mentioned, this boat is for sale, $179,999. If you guys are interested, go ahead and shoot me an email to clay@cowartmedia.com. It's right there up on the screen. You can also shoot me a DM through Instagram, cowart_media. But we're always coming out with new videos on a weekly basis. But ultimately, you're gonna wanna stay tuned because you're gonna wanna see what's coming after this. We appreciate you guys watching. We'll see you next week.